The first stage of motorcycle obsession is moto-curiosity. It's similar to that curiosity you may have felt the first time you had to shower in the locker room after middle school gym class, except motorcycling might have even more alpha males. In this stage, your first exposure to the motorcycle contagion will work its way into your brain and start consuming your thoughts. For a lot of new and moto-curious or bike-curious riders, your social media algorithm may have blessed you with some suggested content surrounding bikes. Maybe some shirtless hunk on a leader bike showed up on your TikTok For You page, talking about how easy it is to pick up babes when you ride a motorcycle. Maybe you were shown a viral video of raunchy police officer interaction with a motorcyclist, or a spicy road rage incident brought to you by World Star! While these highly proliferated representations of motorcycles do not necessarily show the two-wheeled lifestyle in its best light, it did do the job of getting bikes on your radar. They provided you with a more intimate look into motorcycling that may have eluded you previously. Or maybe you don't have brain rot and you were first exposed to motorcycles the old-fashioned way, through real human-life interactions. Sometimes a friend or family takes the plunge and you get introduced to motorcycling by proxy. Sort of hypothetically, your mom left your dad for a younger guy who rides a Harley-Davidson. You might think, well, if a motorcycle is cool enough to make my mom leave my dad, then I gotta ride too if I ever want to earn her affection. A lot of times, people who end up on motorcycles have had a lifelong interest in riding, whether it be through family members who ride, or the depiction of bikes in movies or TV, or maybe they were just a super rad early 2000s or 90s kid who grew up wearing No Fear shirts and listening to Slipknot and watching the X Games, where getting a motorcycle was kind of an inevitable facet of your perpetually extreme lifestyle. I think a lot of you can relate. That's how I grew up. Some people catch the bug, but it lays dormant and incubates for years before they choose to act on it. For others, it is nearly immediate how quickly their exposure turns into a reality. On a personal level, I knew I wanted to own a motorcycle by the time I was like 11 years old. So yeah, fast forward like 11 years after that, and I already had one. So it took a while. But once your curiosity has been piqued, the next stage of motorcycle obsession is research and realization. This is the stage where prospective motorcyclists who, having never actually ridden a motorcycle of their own, start espousing serious hot takes on YouTube and social media forums based solely on the opinions of other people that they have read or seen online. Nobody is ready to die on a hill in defense of a certain motorcycle more willingly than the heavily researched rider who has never actually ridden a motorcycle themselves. But there are many important aspects to being an informed and educated potential motorcyclist. For those who want to ride but don't have the patience or skills to research the best and most appropriate avenue into riding, they'll likely end up riding their buddy's 2000s Gixxer, take a few practice laps in a parking lot, and then head to the freeway for some roll racing. And as you may be able to infer, these types of riders don't always stick around too long. They'll either usually be too scared out of riding or just entirely yeeted out of existence, unfortunately. With that being said, it is definitely encouraged to do your research before riding. There is more valuable online resources for riders than ever, and there are countless friendly furries on our Discord server who would be more than happy to answer any question you might have. Just don't talk to them about literally anything else. It is at this stage of obsession where your curiosity is fueled by research, and you start making tangible plans for learning how to ride and buying your first bike. In the next stage, you actually take the plunge. Much to the chagrin of your loved ones, you've signed up for the MSF course and you've begun shopping around for your first bike. It is at this stage that no matter how many arbitrary facts you learned about the SV650 or Valentino Rossi's racing achievements, that you actually know nothing about riding. Your head's gonna be packed full of information that fluctuates between useful and useless, but your muscles have atrophied from years of trolling Reddit and 4chan from the safety of your gaming chair. You'll be a baby squid, humbled by a Rebel 250 in your MSF course. You'll be like a baby giraffe, first learning to walk as you waddle the bike across the parking lot. You'll eventually pass with shining colors, unlike the dyslexic boomers lacking neuroplasticity who are incapable of learning anything during the online classroom portion and then flunk the written exam. With your signed MSF certification in hand, you'll immediately think you're ready to tackle the next group ride. But then you'll buy a beginner sport bike from the dealership and make a mess in your riding jeans after you realize you have zero clue what you're doing to survive the 30-mile ride home. After accomplishing this feat with white knuckles and brown underwear, you'll post a picture of your bike on your Instagram with your caption saying something like, "I did a thing," with a bunch of emojis. You'll immediately put your bike year and model in your social media account bios and assume the identity of a motorcyclist through and through, despite the fact that you still stall every time you try to leave a stop or tip the bike over when you forget to put the kickstand down, you are a rider now. You embody the motorcyclist persona. You are speed. You are rebellion. Riding is life. Before you actually continue to learn as a rider and fine-tune those fundamentals, you'll likely succumb to the next stage, the modification rabbit hole. As a new rider, it's an objective truth that your priority should be seat time. The only mod you should really be worried about is the driver mod, you know, and paying for tires and gas and chain maintenance and the boring stuff. But despite this, a newly obsessed motorcycle owner is quick to let their desire to modify their bike take hold over their motorcycle experience. There is nothing glamorous about practicing slow speed maneuvers in a parking lot. That's just fact, and nobody wants to see that. But bolting up some fresh new generic eBay parts to your beginner sport bike? Now that's a whole other story, baby. The obsessive need to modify your bike is twofold. On one side of the coin, it will allow you to make your bike wholly your own, because nothing screams individuality like a beginner bike decked out in cheap generic parts. But hey, it is fun. Secondly, it will allow you to satisfy your consumerist need to spend. Can't open YouTube without someone from Revzilla begging you to pull out your credit card and add a bottle of Motul's bug wash visor spray to your shopping cart anyway, so make Ari Henning proud. Just spend on it. Just do it. Recklessly spending on motorcycle parts and accessories is a surefire way to milk your brain of any last remaining drops of dopamine you have left after hours of scrolling through motorcycle TikTok. Ultimately, after you've installed your tail tidy, your eBay fart can, your generic low-profile turn signals, and your China Zoma mirrors, you'll realize the futility of your actions. Because once you've dug to the bottom of the modification hole, you'll be there all alone with your diminishing returns, wondering where all the good times went.
Folks, time is running out to win this Ninja 500 that I have on yamminoob.co. We've had a lot of fun with this motorcycle, put a lot of miles on it, but it's time to say goodbye. Head over to the website and become a member for your best chance to win. The sweepstakes is wrapping up, so don't miss our awesome multipliers on all merch purchases on the store as well. But if you become a member, you'll get to find out what the next giveaway bike is and get your entries locked and loaded for that one as well. I'm actually looking at it right over there, and it's a pretty sweet ride. Spoiler alert, it's yellow. Make sure you go to the website and don't miss your chance to win. Time is running out.
The next stage of motorcycle obsession is a dangerous one, even more dangerous than the Farkle obsession: community engagement. One lone squid with only the internet as his companion is already a bit of a danger to society, but a herd of squids all gallivanting around together can have devastating consequences. It's at this stage you'll begin to relish in the ungovernable chaos of a group ride. Your most reckless behaviors will be validated. Your wimpy clutch-up wheelies will be met with praise like, "Bro, that was so sick!" Oh, and your new exhaust sounds brutal, by the way. The cold start video you posted on Instagram legit gave me goosebumps. During this stage of obsession, you will start to feel the strength of the bond felt between riders as they line up their bike side by side for a photo op. Oh boy, there is nothing like a terribly framed photo of five random bikes with a vaguely pleasant landscape in the background of some suburbia to really let people know, this is me. I've always been this way. I'm a biker. These are my people. If you don't like it, you can just leave. Once you sink deeper and deeper into the community aspect of motorcycling, you'll become enveloped in the hive mind. You'll begin to share the same thoughts and ideas with other riders in your group. Your value systems will begin to align. You'll pound on your chest and grunt, R6 good, R9 bad. Ultimately, you'll begin to mature as a rider, assuming you make it this far. You'll start to realize the diminishing returns of excessive mods or unending group rides, and your priorities are going to shift back to real riding with the pursuit of growth and personal fulfillment. This stage can be called motorcycle maturity and education. By this point in your motorcycle obsession, you'll likely realize that the riding that happens in these squid group rides is pretty elementary and very juvenile, and if you want to become a good and competent motorcyclist, not just a brave and lucky motorcyclist, it's at this time you're going to pursue different forms of advanced rider training. This may involve taking a riding course somewhere, pursuing a motorcycle track day, or maybe reading specialized books and practicing on your own with deliberate and purposeful focus on growing your skills. You'll start to enjoy riding in a more intimate way where your personal fulfillment will be directly related to the achieving the goals that pertain to your skill and ability. You will achieve a great sense of confidence as you begin to notice improvements and positive things in your riding skills. You'll handle tight corners with ease, making twisty road riding look like child's play. But despite your increased level of skill and technique, your maturity will diminish your desire to ride like a squid, at least outside the confines of a controlled and safe area. Squidding will always be there. It's like the devil on your shoulder. It never really goes away. You will become obsessed with learning as much as you can to become a talented and competent rider. And the seventh stage of motorcycling is the threat of financial ruin, N+1. N plus one is a common little joke riders say when asked what the ideal number of bikes is, N referring to the number of bikes you own, and plus one meaning you always want for another bike. Pretty clever, right? But really, this can become quite a serious problem for a lot of riders. Once you've gained a lot of experience and garnered a ton of knowledge, you'll likely have realized just how varied the motorcycling landscape is. Then maybe you're going to want a dedicated track bike, maybe you'll want an ADV bike to go touring, maybe you'll want a mini bike to practice wheelies, or maybe you'll want a hyper naked to also practice wheelies, or maybe there's a really good deal on Craigslist on a little TW200 and you really should just get it, and there's that Chinese Grom that's just way too cheap and you gotta just buy it. My point being, there are so many great bikes out there that offer dramatically different riding experience that they can be hard to resist their siren song. N+1 really becomes a problem as you become an older rider because you start to have the financial means to just buy some of these holy grail bikes. You've worked hard to keep that 800 plus credit score, so you may be tempted to take out an egregious loan on a Street Fighter V4S or an S1000RR, or God forbid, a BMW GS. Or on the other side of the coin, you may think you're being savvy by purchasing project bikes to satisfy your N+1 equation. While it may be somewhat true that you can find a good deal on a bike that just needs a little bit of work, it usually ends up being far more cumbersome of an undertaking than you considered. If it really was that easy to get the bike running again, don't you think the previous owner would have done so? I've seen lots of guys end up with a garage full of barely running or non-running project bikes because they were convinced they were getting a good deal. While there are a million different avenues to pursue motorcycling, take it from my personal experience, you're usually better off with a modest stable of one, two, maybe three bikes, and for the sake of your sanity, the bike's welfare, and the health of your bank account, make sure they're all running pretty well. Thanks for making it all the way in, my little squid. You are truly motorcycle obsessed to have made it this far. What stages of obsession did I miss out on? The ridiculous amount of Harley Pirate or ADV Dad cause to play, the baby squid to highway roll racing bandit pipeline, the stage where all your non-riding friends and family start to resent you because all you can talk about is motorcycling. Seriously, it's like every new rider 3 months into it says, "Riding is my life, bro. I've always been this way." Be sure to let me know how obsessed you are down in the comments below. I am still obsessed. I've been at this for 10 years and I freaking love bikes. They're just fun. Two wheels, anything, just a good time. Be sure to subscribe if you enjoyed the video. I will catch you all later. Fact: coastlines cover about 20% of U.S. land area and are home to almost 40% of the U.S. population. That's a lot of people. Goodbye.
There's a way for you to stop being sad. It's getting a motorcycle. And the easiest way to do it, besides stealing one, which I don't recommend, is becoming a member on YamDude.co and winning my giveaway bikes. Yes, this thing right here. End of the sweepstakes coming up. You're not going to want to miss it. November is the last month to get entered. While you're waiting for this next Yammy Noob video to queue up, because you're going to keep watching, become a member. Sign up. Get entered to win. You're not going to want to miss it.